In the following video lesson, we'll be adding a gradient effect to a flower to give it a more three-dimensional look. From the File menu, select New. Let's type in Flower for the title of our document, and set the New Document profile to Print. Then from the Size list, select Letter. Set units to inches and orientation to landscape. Afterwards, click OK. Let's start with the pen tool in the Tools panel and create our first petal on our artboard. We'll click to create our first anchor point, then click and drag on our second anchor point to arch our segment. Then click again on our second anchor point to remove half of our directional handle. Then click and drag on our first anchor point to curve the segment. Next, we'll use the selection tool to select our petal. Then select the rotate tool to position it. To do that, let's click below the tip of the petal to set our reference point. Then, while holding down the Alt key, drag the petal in a circular motion to rotate and copy it. Click back on our reference point. Then hold down the Alt key and click. Then drag the petal to create another copy. Click back on our reference point. Hold down the Alt key and click on the petal. Then drag it. Let's repeat a few more times. Set the reference point, Alt key and click, then drag. Alt key and click, then drag. Next, we'll be adding a gradient to the flower. First, we want to select the selection tool. Then back in the Tools panel, double-click the gradient tool and select one of the petals. Then, in the Gradient panel, click on the Gradient Fill box. This will automatically apply a black and white gradient. To change our gradient setting, double-click on the left gradient stop to open the Color panel. Click on the Flyout menu and select RGB. In the Color panel, enter the following RGB values: 241, 90, and 36. Back in the Gradient panel, double-click on the right gradient stop. Click on the Flyout menu and select RGB. Then in the Color panel, enter RGB values 255, 255, and 255 again. Position the mouse pointer slightly below the bottom edge of the gradient slider, and when the pointer changes to a white arrow with a plus sign, click to add a new gradient stop. Double-click the center gradient stop and enter RGB values 251, 176, and 59. Reposition the gradient stops as desired by clicking and dragging a stop somewhere along the gradient slider. On the artboard, position the mouse pointer just outside the square-shaped gradient annotator, then click and drag to rotate the white side of the gradient towards the center of the petal. You might have to repeat this until you get the desired effect. Next, with the selection tool, hold down the Shift key to select all the petals on the artboard. Then with the eyedropper tool, click the petal that has the gradient fill, which will apply the same gradient to all the petals. With the gradient tool, rotate the gradient for all the petals to have the white side of the gradient toward the center of the flower. Repeat this on all of our petals. To add another add-on to our flower, go back to the Tools panel, click, and hold down the Rectangle tool, then select the Hidden Star tool. On the artboard, click and drag to create a thin star in the center of the flower. Hold down the Control key as you drag, which will allow you to modify the shape of the star. Double-click the Gradient tool. Then in the gradient panel, click on the type arrow and select radial. Double-click the left gradient stop and enter RGB values 255, 247, and 169. Double-click the center gradient stop and enter RGB values 255, 241, and 169. Double-click the right gradient stop and enter RGB values 215 and 0. Drag the gradient stops to position them as desired. You can do this with each stop. Select the Ellipse tool in the Tools panel. Hold down the Shift key and draw a circle in the center of the flower. Double-click the Gradient tool. Then in the Gradient panel, double-click the left gradient stop and enter RGB values 221, 30, and 71. Double-click the center gradient stop and enter RGB values 237, 61, and 87. Then double-click the right gradient stop and enter RGB values 243, 127, and 123. Drag to position the gradient stops as desired. In the Transparency panel, in the Blending Mode list, select Hard Light. And in the Opacity box, type 65. Now the last thing to do is draw a stem for the flower. We'll be using the pen tool from the Tools panel. Create our first anchor point, then click and drag to create our second anchor point. Then click back on our second anchor point before clicking and dragging our third anchor point. Then click on the third anchor point before clicking and dragging our first anchor point. Now let's add a gradient to the stem by double-clicking the Gradient tool in the Tools panel. In the Gradient panel, click the Gradient Fill box. Then from the Type list, select Linear. Double-click the left gradient stop and enter RGB values 209, 228, and 165. Then double-click the center gradient stop and enter RGB values 172, 212, and 121. Finally, double-click the right gradient stop and enter RGB values 118, 184, and 63. Let's use the selection tool to resize and position our stem underneath the flower. Let's create a large enough marquee to select both objects. Next, let's decrease the size of both objects. Click outside of the selection, then select just the flower and decrease its size even more. Let's also rotate our flower before positioning it over our stem. Hold down the Shift key to also select the stem and drag both objects to the center of the artboard. Click anywhere outside the selection to see the final results.